Thank you for your company this morning. Well, William Katt became a worldwide star as an accidental Superman in the TV show The Greatest American Hero. But he nearly took on an even bigger role in a very iconic movie. Angela Bishop recently caught up with William Katt in Hollywood. You know I wish that I had
just seen this girl. It was 1981. Rick Springfield was on top of the global music charts. Mel Gibson was double-dipping at the box office with Gallipoli and Mad Max 2. And a new type of superhero was about to crash onto our television screens.
Look at what's happened to me.
I was doing a play in New York off-Broadway at the time, and Stephen Cannell flew out, who was the creator of Greatest American Hero, and he saw the play, and he took me to dinner afterwards. And I had, by that time, read this really laugh-out-loud, funny script, and I agreed to do it. Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. I never thought I could
feel so free. Flying away all over. The series became a smash hit, and believe it or not, the theme song landed on the Aussie music charts. Believe it or not,
it's just me. I had no idea that the show was going to do what it did. I thought I'd be back in New York because I was living in New York at the time. Surprisingly enough, it did very, very well, and we had a great 3.5-4 year run with it.
What are your greatest memories of it?
The greatest memories are working with Connie.
What on God's earth are you wearing?
And Bob Culp, you know, Robert Culp, who's just a master craftsman.
This is Bill Maxwell. We're in the superhero business together.
Hello.
And how did you deal with worldwide fame?
I had a little taste of it with Carrie.
Extraordinary for you, Tommy Ross.
The 1976 film adaptation of Stephen King's horror novel Carrie launched Katt's career and that of his co-stars John Travolta and Sissy Spacek.
Let's talk about Carrie. Let's talk about your hair in Carrie.
I know. What was with that? Cut your hair.
If you'd like to, we could stop in at the Beehive for a couple minutes.
Never been there.
No?
Good.
What was it like working with Sissy Spacek on that?
Lovely gal.
Yeah?
Brilliant. She's just brilliant. But Piper Laurie got an Academy Award nomination, and so did Sissy. And
yeah.
When we auditioned for that, you know, we auditioned, George Lucas was auditioning for Star Wars, and Brian De Palma was auditioning for Carrie, and they held auditions together.
You auditioned for Luke Skywalker, too,
I did. With Kurt Russell, he and I read together.
Well, we have to find the Rebels. What we're carrying belongs to them.
Well, their bases are very well hidden. And all the power of the Empire can't find them. Do you know where they are?
He's always blamed me for the fact that he never got that role.
Oh, the Han Solo role. That's your fault, is it?
That's my fault.
It's a bit harsh.
He's done all right.
Yeah, he's done okay.
He's done okay.
Today, Carrie is considered a landmark horror classic, but not all of Katt's films were warmly received. The coming-of-age surfing film Big Wednesday, starring Jan Michael Vincent and Gary Busey, flopped when it was first released.
I don't know about any damn party waxer.
Oh, come on, Barlow. Summer's almost over. Let's get radical.
It's no secret it was a huge failure at Warner Brothers at the time. But over the years, it just became this great cult film. And whenever I'm in Hawaii or the one time I was in Australia, I mean, I felt like a celebrity. I can't believe
it myself. These days, Katt splits his time between the stage and screen. And with news that The Greatest American Hero is set for a 2016 reboot, fans are hoping William Katt will again don that famous red suit.
Television at the moment is like where everyone wants to be. They say it's where the greatest things are. Was television considered, you know, a cool thing to do at the time?
Well, I think, you know, when we did that, it was ABC, CBS and NBC, NBC and Channel 11, maybe four or five networks, and that was it. Now there's just, you know,
a gazillion channels.
Lots of channels, and there's a lot of great stuff on TV, right? And on the internet. I think it's a real golden age for creativity, and I do.
Wait, don't go!
We have to thank the Hollywood Show for allowing us to film that interview.